Okie dokie, this is going to be a really quick video this time, but it's going to touch on something that most PS4 owners out there don't know that you can do, and that is that you can actually capture, edit, and publish your own gaming footage all for free. That's right, all you need is a PS4 and an internet connection, and I guess a headset if you want to capture your voice like stupid old me right now. So instead of explaining it all, let's just get right to it. The first thing you're going to need is this video editor called Share Factory. You can get it for free off the PlayStation Store, so go ahead and do that. Once you've got Share Factory installed and ready to go, you're going to want to set up your capture settings. To do this, you just want to go to Settings, Sharing and Broadcasts, and Audio Sharing Settings, and check the Include Microphone Audio and Video Clips box. The last thing you want to do on this screen is check this bottom box. Now, if you're planning on playing in a party with other players and want to record their voices too, they're going to have to check this box as well. A PS4 will not record a person's headset audio unless they give permission here. Now we can back out and look at the only other thing you need to worry about in this screen, and that's the length of video clip. This is pretty self-explanatory. You'll use this to decide how far back you want your PS4 to save a capture after you hit the share button on your controller. Adjust this to your needs, but a good tip is to keep your clip length around the length of a match in whatever game you're playing. This just helps keep things simpler later when you start editing. The process for capturing footage is actually the easiest part. Once you have everything set up the way I showed you, just play the game as you would. And when you want to save a clip, hit the share button on your controller, which is directly left of the trackpad. This will bring up the share quick menu. Scroll down and select save video clip, or just hit square on your controller. After you've captured some footage and want to start making your video, go ahead and open Share Factory and select new project. The next page you get is a theme selection window. This is going to put clips and transitions automatically before and after whichever clips you're going to choose here. This isn't super important because you can delete and add transition and clips as you see fit later, so just pick any of them. Now we're going to actually choose our game captures that we want to put in here and edit. To make this simpler, you can go to Buy Game and pick the game that you were playing, like Apex. Hit X to select as many as you want, and then hit square to load them in. And then you can name it, but it's not really important because you'll be able to name things later, and hit continue. It's going to load in our clips, and here we are. So now that we're actually in the project and in the video editor, we can use the right thumbstick to scroll around, or even the trackpad to kind of go faster. Square is going to give you all your basic editing tools like splitting and deleting and moving clips, whereas X is going to allow you to add screenshots and other clips later, as well as transitions and music. Once you've gotten through all your footage and everything looks good, you're going to want to publish it. To do that, you want to hit back and go to Share Video and Exit. This is going to render out your entire project and then take you to a share screen that'll allow you to share it directly to your YouTube channel. And that's pretty much it. It's a really easy program to use. It does have its limitations, but you can get away with a lot on it. And most importantly, you don't need any computers or anything. It's all done on a PS4 and a headset. Let me know if you want to see more of these. I'm thinking about making some more Share Factory videos. Also, check out our latest video up here. See you later.